what is the total magnetic field? What is the total magnetic field? I know what is DH. Now I should know what is total magnetic field. Okay. See, once if I know, I want to calculate the total magnetic field. It is simply H is equal to line integral over that line carrying the current, line integral carrying the current into DH, into DH. Okay, that is the idea. So line integral, what is DH? Idl r cap divided by 4 pi r square, 4 pi r square. This is the total magnetic field. This is called as Biot-Savart law. Okay, Biot-Savart's law. Okay, this is the basics to calculate the total magnetic field. So now onwards, we will start with this equation only. Okay, to calculate the magnetic field due to infinite line carrying the current I, we'll use this formula. Or to calculate the magnetic field due to the circular ring carrying the current I, circular loop, we'll use this formula. This is the basic formula. Okay, hereafter we will use this formula. We'll start with this. Okay, now the next one is what is the magnetic field due to the infinite line carrying the current I? Okay, the magnetic field due to the infinite line carrying the current I. Okay, so magnetic field due to infinite line carrying current I, magnetic field due to infinite line carrying the current I. This is something lengthy derivation. Anyway, I will solve the derivation because you will have some feel about the coordinate system and everything. Okay, so but please note down once if you go for the coordinate system, which coordinate system we have to use. Okay, once if you take a wire like a structure, definitely you have to take the cylindrical coordinate system. You have to take the cylindrical coordinate system. Okay, so we'll use the cylindrical coordinate system here. Okay, because wire is something similar to cylinder. Okay, wire is something similar to cylinder. Okay, so we'll use a cylindrical coordinate system. Okay, what is the cylindrical coordinate system parameter? Rho comma pi comma z. Okay, cylindrical coordinate system parameter is rho comma pi comma z. Okay, so now okay, this is my z axis. Okay, this is my z axis. This is my y axis. This is my x axis. X, y, z. Okay, now I am placing the current is flowing on the z axis. Okay, from minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay, the current is flowing in the z axis from minus infinity to plus infinity. This is minus infinity, this is plus infinity. My current I is flowing in this direction. Okay, now I should find out what is the again, please be very clear that this is the axis conductor. This is the conductor. Okay, conductor is placed, infinite conductor is placed on the z axis, but the current is flowing from minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay, minus infinity to plus infinity. Now I choose some random point on the xy plane. Okay, on the xy plane. And now I have to choose a small elemental length on the z axis. I choose some small elemental length on the z-axis. This is my small elemental length on the z-axis. I know once if I choose small elemental length, this is my point P. Okay. Once if I choose the point on the xy plane, the point will have rho, rho means radial distance from the z-axis, rho, and it will have some pi. As it is on the xy plane, definitely z value is zero. Definitely, once if you choose a point on the xy plane whose coordinates its coordinates will be rho comma pi comma z, rho comma pi comma z. Okay. Similarly, if you choose a point here, okay, because your elemental length is here, okay. So if you choose a point here, that point will have rho is zero because you are on the z axis. Okay, because rho is always measured from the z axis, so rho is definitely zero, and this is pi, and this is z. And please note down, this pi can be anything actually. This pi can be anything, but here in this case, pi is pi only. But whereas here, pi can be anything. But for simplicity, I take it as a pi because that's why both will cancel actually. Once if I calculate the vector, both will cancel each other. Okay. Now I know I have to connect a point. These two point. I have to connect these two point. Okay. So you connect these two point. Okay. You connect these two point. Once if I connect these two point, that gives you r vector. What it gives? That gives you r vector. Okay. Once if you connect the two point, that gives you r vector. This is the r vector. Okay. From the basics we have seen, once if you connect a point from elemental length to the observation point, that is the direction of r cap. Okay, r vector. Now, what is this? What is this length actually? From the base, from the center point of the coordinate system, if I measure this point, that length is rho. Okay, that length is rho. Okay, radial distance measured from the z-axis. As I am on the xy plane, I can measure it from the center point of the coordinate system. Okay. Now, what is the angle? What is the angle from the xz plane? Now, what is the angle of my point P from the xz plane? That is what, sir? That is this angle. This angle is what? Pi. This angle is pi. Okay. Now, somehow we have completed everything on the diagram. So, this is IDL. Current element IDL. Okay. IDL. Now, what is DL? Okay. What is DL? So, DL is something like DZ. Okay. Because my line, conductor line is on the Z axis. So, DL can be written as DZ. And that too, my current is going on the Z cap direction, AZ cap. That's why DL vector. What is the nature of the DL vector? DL vector means DZ, AZ cap, because my current is flowing on the Z cap direction. Then what has to be my IDL? IDL is equal to I DZ, AZ cap, I DZ, AZ cap. Now, how to find out R vector? How to find out R vector? So I know this point is P, okay? Now I take this point as Q, suppose, for example, I take this point as Q, that elemental line point is as a Q. I have to calculate what vectors are QP vector, not QP vector. QP vector is equal to OP vector minus OQ vector. OP vector minus OQ vector. What is OP vector? Okay, what is the OP vector, sir? OP vector means rho a rho cap, because OP vector means rho a rho cap pi a pi cap. What is OQ vector? So OQ vector means pi a pi cap plus z a z cap plus z a z cap. Just you find out the difference between these two. Okay, difference between OP vector minus OQ vector will give you the R vector. Okay, so that is equal to QP vector. Okay, QP vector is equal to what, sir? R vector. That is OP vector minus OQ vector. So rho a rho cap will be there. This pi component will cancel. Okay, it is present on both the vectors, so it will cancel each other. Then minus z a z cap, minus z a z cap. Now I have calculated R vector. Okay, once if I know R vector, what is my mod value? mod value is really rho square plus z square. Mod value is really rho square to z square. Now, what is my AR cap? What is the unit vector in that direction? Unit vector in that direction AR cap is equal to R vector divided by R vector modulus. R vector modulus. So finally, my unit vector is equal to rho A rho cap minus z A z cap divided by rho square plus z square over all square root. That is my unit vector AR cap vector. Okay, AR cap. Okay, now I know what is AR cap vector. I know what is IDL. Okay, because that is available in the numerator in the Biot-Savart law. That is available in the numerator. So once if I know these two things, these two things you should remember. Okay, just I will note down now. You should know this one. To proceed further, you should know this one, and also you should know this one. These two things you should know to proceed further. Why? Because if you go to the previous slide, you see IDL is there and AR cap is there. Remaining 4 pi is a number or modulus value only. You can take it outside. Okay, so you should know IDL and AR cap. R cap, again, R cap also available there. Magnitude we have just found out. Okay, everything you can easily substitute. Okay, R cap modulus. Okay, so R cap modulus is available here. Okay, you should know this also. What is R cap modulus? Once if you know these three factors, you can easily proceed further with the help of mathematics. You can derive the answer. You can derive the answer. Now, okay, so what is dh? My dh is equal to, generally in any case, dh is equal to IDL AR cap divided by 4 pi mod r square. Now first I will find out IDL cross AR cap. IDL vector AR cap, IDL is equal to IDZ AZ cap. AR cap is rho A rho cap minus z AZ cap divided by rho square z square square root. Okay. Now, what is the cross product of AZ cap with A rho cap? You should know this rho pi z. Okay. Once if you make cross product of z and rho, definitely answer you will get as a pi. Okay. Z. Okay. From z, you are coming to rho. So definitely answer is pi. So the first component is pi component. So that is I rho dz. Okay, a pi cap rho square z square over all square root. Now, what is the cross product of az cap with az cap? Simply it is zero. Okay, cross product of az cap with AZ cap is simply zero. So finally, I have found out what is IDL vector into AR vector. Okay, IDL vector into cross product of AR vector. Okay, this I can substitute there because in the numerator it is available, so I can substitute that. Okay, so so the next page, if I substitute those values, finally H is equal to integral DL I rho DZ 4 pi. Again, in the denominator, there was modulus R square. So modulus R square value is rho square Z square. Modulus R square value is rho square Z square. Already rho square Z square. Square root is also there. Okay. Into A pi cap. This I can simplify rho DL, okay, I rho DZ 4 pi rho square Z square overall 3 by 2 A pi cap. Now, the integration is with respect to DZ. So, okay, so that's why remaining things you can take outside. Okay, once if you take remaining things outside, I rho divided by 4 pi, I rho divided by 4 pi integral minus infinity to plus infinity, okay, dz divided by rho square z square 3 by 2 into a pi cap. Okay, this is completely mathematics. Okay, this is completely mathematics. You just try to find out this value. You go by some substitution. Z equal to rho tan theta, something like that. Okay, Z equal to rho tan theta, something like that. You substitute. Finally, you will get some answer. Finally, you will get some answer. That answer itself, I am writing directly. So, I rho divided by 4 pi, the answer of the integral is 2 divided by rho square. 2 divided by rho square. Okay, so once if you make adjustment, I divided by 2 pi rho a pi cap. Okay, finally my magnetic field is I divided by 2 pi rho into a pi cap. Okay, so what is the final observation? I is equal to, sorry, h is equal to finally, my magnetic field H is equal to I divided by 2 pi rho a pi cap. Okay, so this is something. So 2 pi rho, and please just compare with the electric field. You have calculated the magnetic field due to line. Okay, similarly, in case of electric field due to line charge density, what was electric field due to line charge density? That was rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon A. Okay, instead of rho, we are using A. That's it. Rho also you can use, no problem. So what is the only difference? Everything is same. Instead of I, here you are having rho, because there the source is line charge density. Here the source is current. Okay, source is current. 2 pi is there. Here also 2 pi is there. Here rho is there because rho is also measured from the z axis. Here also a is there. A is also measured from the z axis. Okay, everything is same, but only difference is epsilon. That's why in the beginning itself I have told electric field depend on the medium properties, whereas magnetic field is independent of the properties. Okay, why I am comparing these things? Once if you know electric field nature formulas, you can easily remember the magnetic field formulas. Okay, without any confusion, that is the idea. Okay, so Here, what is the rho is indicating? Rho is normal distance of a point P. Normal distance of point P from the z axis. Why from the z axis? Because z axis is carrying current. Okay, normal distance. Okay, normal perpendicular distance. It should not be measured from the center point of the coordinate system. It has to be measured from the z axis. Normal distance. Okay, normal perpendicular distance. Okay, this is something finally you should remember. Okay, what is the electric field due to infinite line carrying the current I? Okay, this is the value I divided by 2 pi rho. And what is the direction of the magnetic field? See, the direction of magnetic field is in a pi cap direction. What is the meaning of that? Okay. So once if you have the line like this, okay. If you are having the line like this, what is your magnetic field direction? Your magnetic field is going in this way. Okay, your magnetic field is going, this is the direction of a pi. Okay, this is the direction of a pi. And this is the direction of magnetic field. Your magnetic field is really going in the direction of a pi. That means what? Your current is flowing along the z axis. Okay, your current is flowing along the z axis. But your magnetic field is around the conductor in a circular nature. Your H will be like this. Okay, H will be like this. But what happens? Suppose if I am having the line like this. Okay, instead of smaller circle, if I am on the larger circle, what will be my electric, what will be my magnetic field? Now also magnetic field will be in this direction. Okay, now also magnetic field will be direction, but it is very clear that suppose if it is H1, if this case is H2, definitely H2 will be less than H1 because you are far away from the source. You are far away from the source. Definitely your magnetic field will be less, because why the magnetic field will be less? Definitely this will give you the rho 2 will be greater than what, sir? Rho 1 simply gives the radius of the imaginary circle that you have formed, rho 2 or rho 1. So the more away you are from the source that is carrying the current, the lesser the magnetic field. The more closer to the current carrying the conductor, the magnetic field. Okay, so the final idea is magnetic field be around the conductor. Magnetic field will be around the conductor, that too in the circular nature, that too in the circular nature. Okay, so what is the conclusion? The magnetic field would be around the conductor in a circular manner. Okay, magnetic field would be around the conductor in a circular loop, loop form. Okay, so again you can apply right hand thumb rule. See, suppose if you are placing your fingers in this way, you are curling your fingers in this way, right hand, and this is your thumb direction. Okay, so really this direction is the direction of the magnetic field. This is the direction of the magnetic field, and then thumb direction is the direction of the current. Okay, please try to imagine that, because you should know, once the current is flowing towards the thumb, right hand thumb, then what will be the nature of the magnetic field? The curl of your fingers will give the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, please note down that I think internet is slow. So as per right hand rule, as per right hand rule, thumb provides the direction of current, direction of curl of fingers gives the direction of the magnetic field. Direction of curl of finger gives direction of magnetic field. Okay, direction of magnetic field. Okay, this is the idea, direction of magnetic field. Now, next we'll extend our discussion. Now I am having two conductors, okay, carrying the current in the same direction. Okay, the case is like this. Say, note, I am having case one. This is like case one. I am having two conductors carrying current in the same direction, infinite conduct. Two infinite conductor carrying the current in the same direction. Say, for example, if I am having one conductor carrying current in this direction, okay, one more conductor carrying current like this. See, both are carrying current in the same direction, and the magnitude of the current also same. Now, suppose if I am standing here, exactly between the conductor, exactly at the middle, between middle of the conductor, between the conductor, exactly at the middle. Now, what will be my magnetic field at that point? That is a question. So first of all, we'll see what is a magnetic field due to conductor one. So the magnetic field due to conductor one, according to the thumb rule, definitely say it will be like this. Okay, it will be like this. It will be going in this way. Okay. So here it will be going in this way. Similarly, for conductor two, what will be the current nature? What will be the direction of the magnetic field? Definitely for this also, it will be going in the counter clockwise direction. Again, see, exactly in that point, if you see,
addition of two,
not addition, they are in opposite direction. Okay, they are in opposite direction. Okay, both are in opposite direction. So the magnetic field here is zero. Please imagine properly. So they are in opposite direction exactly. So the magnetic field is zero. Okay, so whenever two infinite conductor carrying the current in the same direction, the magnetic field between the conductor, the two exactly at the center point, at the middle of the middle, exactly at the middle, that magnetic field is zero. Magnetic field is zero. Okay, so now, suppose if the conductor carries the current in opposite direction, what happens? Case two. Okay, case two, if the conductor carries the current in the opposite direction, what happens? Case two, conductor carries current in the opposite direction. Okay. Conductor carries current in opposite direction. Okay, opposite direction. Okay, if it is in the this is I in this direction, this is going in the opposite direction. So now this is my middle point. Okay. My magnetic field will be in this direction. Again, here it will be in this direction. Okay, now here current is flowing in the opposite direction, so magnetic field will be in the clockwise direction. Magnetic field will be in the clockwise direction. So clockwise direction in the sense, it will go like this. Okay, so it will go like this, like this, like this. It will go like this. So what happens? Here also H. Your magnetic field gets added, 2H, you are getting 2H. Okay, once if the current is going in the opposite direction, whenever you are standing on the center point between the middle of the conductors, your magnetic field will increase. Whereas in the first case, your magnetic field is zero. Whenever the current flows in the same direction, the magnetic field is zero. When it goes in the opposite direction, the magnetic field gets added. The magnetic field gets added. Okay, so this is some simple scenario. Okay, whenever you are having two parallel conductor, what happens? What is the magnetic field inside the between the conductor? What is the magnetic field between the conductor? Next, you take some note. The observation is electric field due to infinite line. Is there any simple way to remember the electric field? Magnetic field due to infinite line. I'll give you some simple way. Magnetic field due to infinite line. Magnetic field due to infinite line. Okay, so suppose if I am having the infinite line like this, okay, infinite line like this, I draw an imaginary surface. Okay, I can stand. Okay, now I can go like this because if I go on the imaginary surface like this, I will experience a magnetic field because magnetic field will be around the conductor. Okay, or otherwise, if I choose a imaginary circle like this, okay, if I am traveling on this imaginary circle, I will experience some other magnetic field because I am going on the larger circle. Definitely, once if I travel on this green color circle, definitely I will experience a lesser electric field. Okay, say this is my H1, okay, this is my H1, and if I am, this is my H2, this is my H2, definitely my H1 is less than H1 is less than H2, because H1, in case of H1, the observation point and source distance is large in case of H1. In case of H2, the observation point and source are near to each other. Okay, so it's very clear. Once if you go away from the line carrying the current, your magnetic field will decrease. Okay, once if you go away from the line, definitely your magnetic field will decrease. But in the other way, what happens? The magnetic field due to current nature. See that magnetic field is generally directly proportional to the current. If there is more current, there will be more magnetic field. Okay, if there is more current, definitely there will be more magnetic field. That's okay. So, but once if we go far away with respect to distance, okay, your magnetic field will reduce. If rho is more, circle radius is more, so magnetic field will reduce. Okay, so it is directly proportional to I, indirectly proportional to rho. Okay, that's okay. So now, and again, that magnetic field is in a circular nature. You are going on the circular nature, definitely that constant is 2 pi only. So you are going on that magnetic field is going in the rotational manner. Okay, magnetic field is going in the rotational manner. So definitely that constant has to be 2 pi. So finally, magnetic field due to conductor, infinite conductor carrying current I is I divided by 2 pi rho, I divided by 2 pi rho and A rho cap. And what is the unit of magnetic field? The unit of magnetic field is ampere per meter. That is the simple idea to remember what is the magnetic field due to infinite line carrying the current I divided by 2 pi rho. I divided by 2 pi rho or 2 pi A. Okay, so how much time is remaining, Karthi?
So 6 minutes.
Okay, then we will give some break. Okay, we'll